Welcome everyone to another video with me, the Nightmare. Oh wait, should I have stuff in my inventory? Today we're going to have a lot of fun in a brand new YouTube world, which is not a desert world anymore. I wanted to change it. It's now a plains biome, and I really like that. And today we will have a lot of fun. Today I want to check. I have any announcements for today. Let me check. Opening my booklet. No, apparently not. No announcements for... No spoilers. Can look over there. Okay. Well, today we're having a lot of fun. And I think it's time to dive in. So guys, as you totally didn't see anything back there, today we're building Majoras Mask Clock Tower. It's not exactly the same, it's a little different, it has my own details and stuff like that. It's a bit tweaked and not exactly according to the game, which is a really good game, but a very, very, very hard one. I played it, I can't finish it, but I did get to this part, of course, and inside here, have the Happy Mask Salesman. You might be asking, who in the world is the Happy Mask Salesman, and why is he carrying a freaking zombie head? Well, that's because the Happy Mask Salesman is a weird dude in Majora's Mask, who literally, well, before an Ocarina of Time, which is the game before this one, this guy is like a nobody. He just sells masks in their shop. And then in Majora's Mask, he ends up in Termina, which is where this clock tower is. He ends up here, and for some reason, he's inside here and has the power to give me masks and to remove masks. Yep. Or add myself. Like, if you want to become Majora, which is a tribe in Zelda, you can get a mask. It owns all the masks. You get them through him, I think. Some you don't, some you do. And not all of them, I just remembered, you get the four primal masks another way, but you can get the first mask here. And yeah, this is all we have in the inside, so I think it's time to get to the outside. Okay, it's... can't get rid of these things. In the game, you do weird stuff. I don't really remember what I played it a while ago, but what happens is that you get a passageway up here, and then you open this door. I do not remember how, but I think it's time to get in here. Stairs, as you saw right before, we have this. It's not exactly like this in the game, and the clock, it moves upward. This clock, the one of the, man, you can't see the clock, which has a lot of detail like redstone blocks. And you might be asking why I chose these blocks. Well, that's because they look like the ones in the game. But in the game, what happens is that the clock moves up here, and this becomes a battlefield. And there is Deku Link. I chose a parrot head because it's green and like a hoodie. And so yeah, that's Deku Link. And you might be asking, why Deku? And who's Link? You might even be asking, who's Link? If you're Link, you're not Link. Well, Link is the main character in every Zelda game. If you thought, Zelda's the main character in Zelda games, well, I think you should go away. Yeah, whatever. Link is the main character in every Zelda game, normally, I think. I don't know any of the Zelda games that don't, that it, Link isn't in. But he became a Deku. A Deku is like like a sprout, like a mini tree that walks. And I'm going to show you a photo of one of them on screen. So you saw that, and then Deku Link has his fairy, Navi, something like that. And Navi help. No, in the, this is not Navi. Navi is in another game. Navi is in my in Ocarina of Time. What's his name? Let's Google it, okay? Let it open. What is Link's fairy called in Majora's Mask? Okay, let's see if my computer likes to load. I don't think it'll load, guys. Okay, I saw it. Tattle, yeah, Tattle. And well, Link's enemy right now is Skullkit, because Skullkit stole his horse, I think, and made him a Sprout the Deku. It's a really cool game, though. Here we have Skullkit, and Skullkit is really mean. So you guys just saw Skullkit, and Skullkit is using the Majoras Mask, as the name is called. And actually, here, let me go over here. Happy Mask Salesman is the one who had the mask, and people believe he was like a god and stuff, because when you go to the moon, it should be crushing everyone by this point. And you see a lot of like Happy Mask Salesman with Majora's Mask skulls. So it's a really weird game. But overall, Skullkit has the power to control the moon, and the moon crushes everyone in 3 days. So you have 3 days to get one mask, if you get one mask, and return to the first day with songs, with your ocarina. And you keep your mask and lose like stuff like arrows and bombs, but keep the most important stuff. And when you get the four masks, they stop the moon, so you can, I think you can hop into it, something like that. I didn't finish the game, I just watched videos later on. So yeah, that's what happened. But Skullkit, I don't even know what Skullkit wants. I think he wants to destroy the world, I guess. And he has his fairy as well. Let me look it up. Let's see, okay. Tattle's brother in Zelda. Tile, yeah. Tile. Okay, I'll put it on the screen right now. Like the spelling. So yeah. This is technically all that I have to show you guys. So thank you so much for watching. This was really, 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 really fun to make. I really enjoyed it. And I guess I'll see you in the next